just what compels me to have this unconditional love for LD. I know it's not that he's mentally healthy. Certainly not that he's graciously wealthy, cause he looks like a serpent, like some sort of weird grumpy juicy urchin, to whom all social niceties are a burden. And plus with that face, I'm shocked he's not a virgin.
He's all sideburns,
cause he's like a seahorse, but the kind of seahorse who's unafraid to incorporate his real life divorce to a TV show with apparently no remorse.
So
to a dick like him, that's just par for the course. Head so bald, heart so cold, beady little eyes peer right into my soul. As far as humans go, he's the all-time rudest. So nervous he's making Richard Lewis
there
look like
no
a Buddhist.
There ain't no other way to say,
go to church on Sunday, not me. I got HBO, I'm watching my TV. I'm watching my boy Larry unintentionally piss off everybody in the world that he ever meets.
So mean.
Kick your enthusiasm to the curb.
Yep.
Post up on your couch, burn a little herb. Watch Larry be a grouch. He walks with a slouch, he talks with a whine, but Cheryl is fine with it. Jeff is cool with it. Leon too. You know Susie's gonna bitch. What the hell's he gonna do?
Bitch back.
You got a question? He got the answer. The man is the man who created George Costanza. He can't stand ya, but he's the boss. Someone tell that to Andy Samberg and Tony Danza. One got LeBron, Jay's taking Dwayne Wade. Third pick in the draft, snakes are taking Larry David.
There ain't no other way to say, I think about him every day. I'm in love with Larry David. I'm in love with Larry David. With that face and that hair, he's so mean, I don't care. Larry David, I'm in love with Larry David.
Across the river from the Jersey Shore, we found shelter from the storm inside Mercy Corps, a complex institution devoted to conflict resolution.
Raj punched my cheek.
I did what worked before. Found Raj, asked him for his version of events. His little cousin Ikra started screaming his defense. If we were all competent parents, perhaps we all could have been friends. The boys failed to shake hands, and I made the mistake to take a stand. When I mediated at previous playdates, they resolved damn near breakdance. No one told me only interfere when your son is the aggressor. The kid left my son hanging in the air. I said, what, too much pressure? The same pressure as the fist that kissed his cheek. The kid went to his mommy's lap to weep, and she freaked out at me in front of the site director, who later disinvited me from giving that special lecture. I bumped into the mom again at soccer the next week.
If you ever talk to my son again, I'm going to call the police.
She approached the coach, gestured towards me, while I wondered what the heck to do besides record this story. The kid kept leaving the field, she dragged him back. He nestled his head in her shirt for the first time it occurred. Perhaps he's special ed. Meanwhile, a fun tyke climbed my son's bike. She tried to strike up conversation, unlike that freaking nanny planning something to the mobile device. I'm the one who talks to these mofos, treats them as equals, but don't talk to people you don't know applies to me too. Ooh.
It's Larry.
Your mommy. I love you, Larry. For real.